Hello? Is anyone there? The house seems empty. I hope nobody minds whether I take a peek inside.
Thank you. kitchen.
Oh my.
Shit, what the?
Got it. Good. Time to play detective.
Thank you.
mushroom I'm looking for. Oh my god. Clearly, this is the wardrobe.
What is this?
Could Father have left it behind? Father, if he's really in his office. Thank you. what's actually there.
Oh, fucking hell. God damn it.
There was Färber. God. I don't even want to think about what must have happened in his final moments. As he was hanging from that noose with the bloody music box on the table next to him. I don't want to think about it, but somehow, very deep within me, I know the song was playing throughout his agony, stalking him to the very frontier between life and death. God. At least we had found the music box, and we knew where it came from. The Grant Amsburg Auction, it said, on the list of product lots, alongside an address. According to Husha, things had improved after returning the box to Färber. So by returning it to its owner, perhaps we might be able to solve all this. It sounded unlikely, but considering my hallucinations, the things we found at the antique shop, and Mr. Farber's terrible end, if it could all come to some good, we had to try it. Isolated far from the world, in a holiday manor that must be about 100 years old, the lady who owned the sinister box awaited us. For my little Ariadne read the engraving on the inside of the cover. Good for her then.
Doesn't seem like the ideal place to find an old lady. Do you think she still lives here?
I don't know. The papers from the auction stated that the owner had sold most of her furniture, but that she still lived here. Mr. Grant? Hello? This place gives me the creeps. Hello? Are you Miss LeGrant? Ariadne LeGrant?
Amsburg?
Pardon me?
LeGrant Amsburg. It's hyphenated.
Oh. Well, my name is Daniel Neuer, and I work for a publishing firm. Through a series of chance occurrences, I found something I believe is yours. It seems crazy, but when you listen to it...
That's its box.
No, I think it belongs to you. On the cover, it says...
I wasn't speaking to you. Thank you for bringing it back, Mr. Neuer. Have you listened to it?
Yes.
He has listened to it.
Whew. She seems disturbed. She grabbed the music box as if she truly needed it.
The important thing is she took it. Let's get out of here. Thanks for letting me sleep here.
Of course. Whatever you need. I'll even let you sleep on the couch.
It's more than enough. I just need a couple of nights. That will suffice. I don't feel like staying in an empty house after everything that's gone on.
You can stay as long as you want. Seriously.
Thanks.
At least I know you won't drink my wine.
Very funny.
What?
Hey, Sophie?
Daniel, are you all right?
That had not been a nightmare. I was awake, for certain. It was a hallucination. A hallucination like... like those described by Färber in his letter, shortly before hanging himself from a beam in his office. A hallucination. Or something worse. Much worse. Had it done any good to return the music box to its owner? Husha might have the answer, but his whereabouts was still unknown, and his trail seemed to have gone cold as the days passed by. Perhaps in his office, somewhere in his papers, among the documents he was researching while delving into the box's origins. Maybe there would be some clue in there as to where he had gone or what he had done. Something that would help us to follow his footsteps. I had to find Sebastian Husha, but this time, my life depended on it.